Now, welcome, and for this lesson, there's something very important that you should note on the energy levels in the structure of the atoms. Now, what we realize is that we say that energy levels contain the electrons. This is where the electrons of the atoms are located. The electrons of the atoms are located on the energy levels. Now, again, you should note that the number of energy levels varies from elements. And what determines the number of energy levels that the an atom of an element will have is the number of electrons. So really, electrons are the ones that determine the number of energy levels. So for our case, it is very important to note that the first energy level, that is the energy level surrounding the nucleus. So we have maybe our nucleus there, protons and neutrons. The first energy level like that, that is the first energy level, will take a maximum of 2 electrons. So first energy level will take a maximum of 2 electrons. The first one is a maximum of 2 electrons. Now, if we have an atom which has more than 2 electrons, what happens is that you must come up with another energy level. So that if you have 3 electrons, then the third electron will jump to the third energy level like that. So the second energy level, of course, if we have 4 electrons, then of course the other electron will be the second energy level, 5 electrons, etc. So what happens is that the second energy level can contain a maximum of 8 electrons. It contains a maximum of 8 electrons. So if you have 10 electrons, what will happen is that you put the first 2 in the first energy level. So 1, 2. From the 10, 1, 2. So 2 minus 10, that means you are remaining with 8 electrons. So you will jump with your electrons to the second energy level. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the second energy level, remember, can carry only a maximum of 8 electrons. So if you add 10 electrons, that means that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So please note this, that the second energy level can only contain a maximum of 8 electrons. Same case to the third energy level. So while it will have maybe another third energy level, then this one will also have a maximum of 8 electrons. So if you have maybe something like an element or an atom with, let's say, 18 electrons, you'll do the first energy level, put 2, so you are remaining with 16. In the second energy level, put 8, you are remaining with another 8, so that you draw again another energy level like that. So each and every energy level has its specific number of electrons that it can carry. So if you add 18 electrons, so these ones are already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you are remaining with 8 more. So you fix your 8 on the third energy level. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. To get a total of 18 electrons. Now, what if you are required to, or you have an atom which has maybe around 19 or 20 electrons. So in this case also, all you have to do is to draw another energy level. So these are already 18. So if you your atom has 19 electrons, then this means that in the other energy level, that's where you draw another electron, which is showing the 19th electron. So that is how the energy levels go about. The first one can take a maximum of 2, second one a maximum of 8, the third one a maximum of 8. And of course, since we are only dealing with the first 20 electrons. Then our last one, the fourth energy level, will have a maximum of 2 electrons. So that's 2 plus 8, that is 10. 10 plus 8, that is 18. Plus 2, that is 20. So that's all. That's the information that you need to know about the atoms for you to draw the structures for the first 20 electrons. Thank you.